Welcome to Servant of the Fates. We'll use tarot and oracle to deliver advice from your higher self. Pick the card that sparks a memory in you. It has your answer. Guidelines below on how to do just that. Feel free to pause this video as you take your pick. As always, timestamps down below. And let's begin. If you chose love, welcome to your reading. It's timeless. You are meant to see it right now. So, what does your higher self want to give you as an advice? Let's start with the tarot. The Four of Pentacles. The Page of Pentacles. The King of Pentacles. The Devil. And the Six of Wands. Darling, you have a lot of earth energy. Pentacles are earth, and then you have Capricorn, the Devil. So this is all about finances or stability in other forms, okay? Right now, your higher self wants you to be more proud of everything that you have achieved, right? And wants you to be even more ambitious when it comes to your aims, your goals in life. Here at the beginning of your spread, we have the Four of Pentacles. Look at him, right? He's sitting there trying to really be, you know, protective of everything that he has. He's holding that pentacle, stepping on the other two so that other people can't get to them, then proudly wearing the last one above his head on his crown. So this is what your higher self wants you to do right now, okay? The things that you have already attained, right? The dreams that you have already fulfilled, be proud of them, flaunt them. It's not the same as bragging, okay? It's just acknowledging your successes so that you can achieve more, so that you can be happier, right? Trying to protect things that you already have, right? Trying to be caring and nurturing. Do you see him holding that? Trying to be nurturing of your skills as well, of your talents, of your beauty, right? Trying to be more proud of everything that you already have, okay? And then this is followed by two cards that echo this message. You have the Page of Pentacles followed by the King of Pentacles. So it's the same thing, darling. Right now, your higher self feels like you're only embodying a page, okay? You are proud of yourself, of your achievements, but only a little bit. You're being ambitious and wanting to achieve more so that you can be happier, so that you can be more successful, but only a little bit, not enough, right? This is the energy that your higher self wants you to embody and exude, right? Not just a page, not someone a bit young and immature, although hardworking, right? But it's kind of insufficient compared to the King of Pentacles, right? The most stable guy in the minor arcana of tarot. So this, see, raise that pride a bit higher, right? Look up even further, right? Try to be more ambitious. Try to be more aggressive in getting what you want, right? The treatment that you deserve from people, demand it. Respect, right? Care, you know, to be emotionally healthy, emotionally stable, right? And also to be more financially stable, right? When it comes to your life. So pentacles, they're all about stability. This could be physical, mental, emotional. All of this is covered. Your higher self wants you to grow your pride and your ambition so that you can be more stable overall as a person. And here is the problem, darling. The Devil. Your higher self thinks that you are worried that other people as well as yourself will judge you if you do this, right? If you flaunt your beauty, if you appreciate your skills, you know, maybe you're narcissistic, maybe you're vain, maybe people will hate you, right? Despise you, resent you, and you yourself, maybe you're not going to like it. You're going to think, you know, you're someone who's too proud and egotistic and narcissistic and you don't want to be that person. But darling, it's not the same thing, okay? This is not the truth. Nobody's going to see you this way. You yourself should not see yourself this way because you do have something to be proud of, the Four of Pentacles, and, you know, nurturing that, protecting that, that is not vanity. That is not narcissism, right? This is gratitude to the universe, to the divine, to the world for having given you, having helped you achieve these things for yourself. Right? There's a difference between bragging and being grateful. And right now you are confused as to the difference. Your higher self thinks that right now you think trying to want more and be more ambitious is the opposite of being grateful, right? You think it's, you know, greed and avarice. Well, it's not, darling. This is what's bothering you right now, okay? You think that if you want more, if you're more proud of yourself, if you try to achieve more and want more things for your future, then this is who you're being, someone materialistic, but that is not true, okay? Wanting to grow is very important. It is true, your higher self is telling me, I'm hearing, it's true that in life, it's love, like the car that you chose. It's what matters, love. Harmony, friendship, peace, right? Tranquility, serenity, joy. But these things are actually impossible to enjoy if you don't have stability, right? It's hard to enjoy a romance when you can't even eat 3 times a day. It's hard to be happy and have peace of mind when you can't even afford to pay the rent. So it's okay. It's okay to want more things for your career, for your finances. This is not the truth, okay? You are not being selfish, you're not being vain, narcissistic, materialistic, no. You are just looking out for yourself, right? And that's what we all have to do. So your higher self is telling you not to feel guilty for wanting more, okay? Be more aggressive, okay? If you want a better job, if you want a better pay, then ask for it, demand it, you know? If you want a better working place, then go apply on LinkedIn. Right? Look for other opportunities. This is about increasing, growing your efforts and your pride in yourself, right? Your ambitions for the future. And look, darling, this is your ultimate outcome, the Six of Wands. So victory, success is guaranteed if you do perform this change that your higher self is asking you to do, okay? This is who you're going to be. Sitting atop your horse, enjoying your success, and the people that you are afraid will judge you as materialistic and selfish and vain. No, here they are supporting you, cheering you on, your loved ones, your family, your friends, being very happy for you, okay? Being very supportive of everything that you have achieved. So, darling, that is your advice from your higher self, okay? Protect, right? Protect and nourish your ambitions. Be more, you know, be more aggressive when it comes to trying to improve your future and be proud of everything that you have already attained, right? Be prouder. It's not vanity. It's gratitude, okay? This is your advice from your higher self. Let's see what your oracles have to add to this. Nobility and self-esteem. It's the same thing. This beautiful Magnolia card is an echo of everything that I just said. It says, there is nothing noble in being superior to your fellow men. True nobility lies in being superior to your former self. And that is why this is not true, this devil energy that you're afraid of, right? It's not, you know, it's non-existent because what you're doing, when you aim to be more ambitious, when you're prouder of yourself, you are not trying to be superior to other people. You're trying to be superior to your past self, okay? It's only yourself that you're competing with, that you're trying to conquer, and there's no sin in that, right? There is no shame in that. It's all about gratitude. It's all about ambitions and just trying to grow as a person, okay? Your last oracle is cheerfulness. Feel lighter, darling. This is such a heavy energy. The devil, right? And like we said, you know, your higher self thinks that this is non-existent, okay? Don't be afraid of this. This is just an illusion. Try instead to embody cheerfulness. It is spring again. The earth is like a child that knows poems by heart. So this is the energy that your higher self wants you to embody, right? Be cheerful in trying to increase your ambitiousness. Okay, it's not ambition for the sake of ambition. It's ambition so that you can enjoy life more. Competition is important, right? Achievements are important. They make you feel happy, right? They make you feel victorious, and that is why we have this Six of Wands here. So, darling, your advice from your higher self, don't be afraid of being seen by other people and by your own self as this devil energy, okay? Wanting more, being proud of yourself, this is all about gratitude and knowing your value, knowing your worth, appreciating yourself and the way that the gods, the divine, the universe, your higher power has made you, okay? It's not trying to be superior to other people. It's not about being vain or egotistic, right, or materialistic. It's just about trying to make the best out of life. And if you do this, if you embody this beautiful cheerfulness, right, and understand nobility and self-esteem, then this is guaranteed for you. The Six of Wands, victory, triumph, and eventually happiness and the support of everyone around you. I hope you enjoyed your reading. Thank you for joining me today, and I hope to see you again soon. Take care. If you chose joy, welcome to your reading. It's timeless. You are meant to see it right now. So, what does your higher self want to give you as an advice? Let's start with tarot. The Page of Swords. The Knight of Cups. The Page of Cups. The Three of Pentacles. And the Two of Wands. Darling, no wonder you chose joy, because right now you are outside looking in, right? There's not a lot of happiness right now in your life emotionally. And that is why this advice from your higher self, this reading, it is all about relationships, romantic or otherwise, right? Romantic, friendship, familial, professional. This is all about how you deal with other people. So right now, darling, this is you. Your higher self is looking down on you and seeing this. You are being very defensive right now. Do you see your stance? Look, right? You're so closed off. So many layers of clothing trying to protect you, right? Building this wall around you. And then you have this sword ready to go in case someone comes too close, right? And the Page of Swords, he is the most rigid, the most emotionally attached of all of the pages. So this is the energy that you're embodying right now. Why? Because you're looking out there. You're afraid that if you put yourself out there, you know, romantically or not, right? If you make this offer, you know, to ask someone out on a date or to ask someone if they want to be friends or to ask to hang out with a group of people, you feel like they're going to reject you or disappoint you, right? One way or another. And so look at you. You're so closed off. You're so serious. You're outside looking in. You're lonely, but you're more afraid of being hurt than of loneliness right now. Okay, so this is you isolating yourself, being very defensive, right? This is the energy that you're embodying. But darling, it is all an illusion. Your higher self is asking you to put yourself out there. The Knight of Cups. To offer your cup of affections and emotions to this person romantically, to this person as a friend, or to a group of people, right? For them to be your community. I mean, look at how dressed you are. All of these clothings as symbology, right? Symbolizing, representing your wall that you have up, right? Surrounding you. But look at him, he's naked. So this is what your higher self wants you to do. Put yourself out there. Tell people about who you are, right? I mean, express yourself through fashion, through accessories, through language, through song, through creativity and art. Let them know who you are. Offer up your emotions, your thoughts, right? You have a lot to offer people, and it's time to ask that guy out on a date, to ask that girl out to the movies, right? It's time to tell this group of people that you want to hang out, you want to have brunch, right? You want to be friends with them, that you have the same interests. It's time to put yourself out there, darling, because this is an illusion. This fear that they're going to reject you or disappoint you, don't worry about it. This is just you overthinking. I mean, the Suit of Swords is all about thoughts. And in this case, it's about overthinking. It's about pessimism. It's about negativity. And it's just an illusion. So your higher self wants you, darling, to go out there and offer yourself up. Let people know who you are. Express your true self and offer up your emotions. Why? Because this is what's going to happen. They are going to reciprocate. Look at them toasting each other, right? This is what's going to happen, darling. If you put yourself out there, if you give this offer of love, this offer of attention, affection, friendship, they are going to give you the same thing. They're going to receive it, and they're going to be so happy about it. Do you see him? He's ecstatic. He's like, oh, thank God. I always kind of, you know, suspected that she liked me, but I was never sure, and I'm so happy that she does. I mean, look, their emotions is represented by the fish. You know, it's actually leaping out of their hearts, out of their cups. So they are going to reciprocate you, darling. This potential lover or friend or group of friends, they are going to appreciate you, right? They're going to reciprocate, mirror, echo your efforts, darling. They are going to welcome you. They are not going to disappoint you. This is the outcome of this relationship forming. The Three of Pentacles. This is so beautiful. This is about you and this person or people having different strengths but working together. I mean, here you have an architect, right? He's the one who draws everything, who measures and plans everything. And then this is you, right? You're the actual stonemason. You're the actual carpenter, you know, executing these ideas. So it's about harmony. Maybe you're afraid that, you know, you're overthinking that, oh, but they're so different from me. I mean, I like Harry Potter and they like the Lord of the Rings. You know, it's like some sort of rivalry and you're afraid that there's going to be a clash in your tastes and your attitudes and your behavior. But no, darling, this is the final outcome, right? In some ways, you're going to be similar, both court cards from the Suit of Cups, right? But in some ways, you're going to be different, of course, because individuals are unique. So one of you is going to be like this, maybe more introverted, more bookish, right? And the other person is going to be like this, right? Maybe more out there, more extroverted, but you're going to work together. Your strengths are going to blend in so that you can create something beautiful, a beautiful connection, a beautiful romance, partnership, or friendship. This card is also about appreciation. This is about recognizing each other's efforts, knowing that he cannot do what he's doing and he cannot do what he's doing. So they need each other. This is about harmony, right? This is about reciprocity, darling. This is so beautiful. This is what's guaranteed if you just let your guard down and start offering up who you really are to this person or to these people, okay? It's beautiful. So in essence, your higher self wants you to end this energy and begin this Two of Cups energy, okay? Right now you're looking out there into the world and you're holding a sword. You're afraid to you're afraid that you're going to need to strike other people for rejecting you, for disappointing you. Look at you. Look at your legs. Look at your stance. So closed off. Look at the layers of clothing. This instead is what your higher self wants you to embody. This is you looking out into the world, right? And knowing that you have your future in your hands, that you have control, that you have the power to make this romance work, to make this friendship begin, right? And look, right, off shoulder. It's about you letting your guard down, darling. It's about you letting people in, right? So this is what your higher self wants you to do, to be less fearful of putting yourself out there, right? And I'm hearing that you've probably been hurt before, but your higher self is saying that right now, this person that's on your mind or these people that are on your mind in your environment right now, it is safe for you to love. It is safe for you to put yourself out there, because when you do, they are going to mirror your energy and they are going to blend with you, right? In harmony and reciprocity. This is what's going to happen. So the world, your future, the future of this relationship, of this connection is in your hands. Let your guard down a little bit and you can achieve all of it. Let's see what your oracles have to add to this. We have strength of character and moral integrity. Darling, this is so beautiful. It goes both ways, right? Stop thinking of yourself as weak, because essentially that's what you're doing. When you're afraid to be vulnerable, it's because you think you're weak. Deep down, you think you're weak, right? That the slightest offense is going to destroy you, right? That the slightest rejection is going to hurt you and harm you and make you crumble, right? So no, recognize your strength. Know that you are strong, okay? You're not going to come crashing down. Everything is going to be fine. You are complete in yourself and you shouldn't be afraid to put yourself out there, because you have a lot to be proud of. You are strong and you are beautiful, but also moral integrity for other people, right? Stop thinking that everyone is out to get you, that everyone is out to, you know, to hurt you, to disappoint you, to reject you, okay? Start thinking better of people. You have been hurt before, yes, but this time around, the people in your environment, they are better, okay? They are people who can reciprocate you. They are people who will appreciate you, okay? So don't worry about that. Your card says, character cannot be developed in ease and quiet. Only through experiences of trial and suffering can the soul be strengthened, vision cleared, ambition inspired, and success achieved. So darling, growth is impossible if you're just standing there, parked, not doing anything, right? Growth can only happen, right? Growth can only be achieved. Happiness and joy can only be attained if you put yourself out there, right? Really put yourself out there because everything is going to turn out fine. Your last oracle is destiny. Wow. Darling, look, this is you taking over your destiny, right? Not being afraid anymore. Really taking everything in your own hands. It says, it is not in the stars to hold our destiny, but in ourselves, you know. Astrology, it's just a map, right? Astrology is a map. The stars are a map, but you have to actually put yourself out there and take the steps so that you can achieve your destiny, so that you can get to the destination. And right now you're not doing that. You're just standing there afraid, watching. No, darling. Okay, it's time to start journeying towards your destiny. That is your advice from your higher self. I hope you enjoyed your reading. Thank you for joining me today, and I hope to see you again soon. Take care. If you chose wealth, welcome to your reading. It's timeless. You are meant to see it right now. So, what advice does your higher self have for you? Let's start with tarot. The Seven of Cups. Strength. The Four of Wands. The Queen of Pentacles. And the Chariot. Darling, you are facing a choice right now and you're afraid to take your pick. The Seven of Cups, right? This is the opposite of a dilemma. A dilemma is when you have to pick between two negative things and you have to choose what's the lesser evil. The Seven of Cups, you are faced with a variety of positive choices, but you can only pick one, right? In this case, here you have power, glory, riches, wisdom, spirituality, romance, and stability. And you are so afraid to take a pick, right? This is where you are right now. And understandably so, okay? Because maybe this is a big choice. Maybe this is about where you're going to work, where you're going to live, who you're going to live with, right? Maybe this is about, you know, a big decision in your life, something to do with romance, something to do with your career, with your studies, with finances, right? But your higher self is asking you to be brave, right? The card of Leo, right? Strength. This is all about bravery. This is knowing that, you know, you have to trust in yourself. You have to be certain. Right now, this is Libra energy, right? Being afraid to make a choice, but this is the energy that your higher self wants you to embody. Being brave to take that risk, right? Leo energy. So it's time to tame your fears, darling. It's time to really, you know, take that pick and just choose what you think is best for you. Follow your heart. Listen to your soul and everything is going to be all right. No matter how big and ferocious it looks like, right? This path, you will be able to tame it and everything will be fine, okay? That is what your higher self wants you to know. And that is why in the middle of your spread, we have the Four of Wands. Darling, this is all about stability. Four of Wands, right? So something very stable. Look at them, they're bridesmaids too. This is a wedding card. So if you are choosing between two people, right? Know that after you make that choice, you are going to enjoy this energy. It's going to be a stable relationship. It's going to be romantic. Look at all the flowers. It's going to be beautiful and enjoyable. And your clue, right? If you're choosing between two men or two women indeed, then here we have Leo. Strength. So this is your advice from your higher self. Someone who's extroverted, right? Someone with fire energy. This is the person that you should go with because wands are also fire, right? In addition to strength, wands are also fire. And this beautiful, glorious energy, this beautiful celebratory energy is something that you can enjoy with this person, okay? Now, we could maybe talking about something other than romance, okay? Maybe we're talking about a job. Then this card is saying that this is going to be a stable job, right? You're not going to stay here for just a few months or weeks or even a couple of years. This is something that you're going to really stay true to, right? This is something that's going to last in your life. And that is followed by another card that mirrors it, right? The Queen of Pentacles is the most financially stable, right? And also mentally, emotionally stable. Pentacles are all about stability, right? Many facets of stability. She is the most stable of all of the queens, especially financially. So at first it's going to start, you know, very happy, right? Very ecstatic, and then it's going to develop into actual stability, right? This relationship, this job, you know, after you make that choice, you are going to feel joyful, and then you are going to feel very secure, right? In the choice that you made. This is you on your throne with your pentacle, with that romance, with that relationship, with that career, knowing that you are at your best, right? Knowing that you have it all. What is better than stability though? Growth. And that is your final outcome, the Chariot. The Chariot is about an upgrade. It's about forward movement. So yes, there's going to be joy and stability. Yes, there's going to be security and solidity. But more than that, it's going to keep on improving. It's going to keep moving forward. So darling, just take that pick, okay? Deep down, you already know which one you want, but you are so afraid of the risks. Libra energy, right? Being so indecisive. But you have to be brave, Leo energy, right? It's time to make that choice, because after you do, it's over. The pain, the agony, the negativity, the pessimism, it's over. From here on out, everything's beautiful. Celebrations, stability, right? Durability, security, solidity, and then forward movement, upgrade, right? This is what awaits you, darling. Such beautiful energy. Right now, if we're talking about something other than romance, if we're talking about a group of people, you know, members of your family, members of your social circle, then these are the zodiac signs that are positive and can help you. I already mentioned Leo, right? But we also have Capricorn and we also have Cancer. So those are your clues from your higher self as to the people who can help you in this situation. Okay, so darling, your higher self is saying it's time to make that choice. Nothing but positivity awaits you after you do. Okay, it's time to be brave, right? Stop being afraid of the risks and start thinking of enjoying the rewards, okay? Because stability is there for you. And if we are talking about money, I mean, you picked wealth after all, then this is a very positive omen. The Queen of Pentacles, the richest of all the queens, right? She is here in your future if you just stop being afraid of making that choice. Let's see what your oracles have to add to this. We have rainbows and messages, very positive. This is about optimism. This is about, you know, forgetting about the risks for a moment and just really thinking about the rewards, just like I said. When it rains, look for rainbows. When it's dark, look for stars. So this is Jupiter energy, right? This is expansion. This is abundance. This is luck. This is always looking at the brighter side of life, right? How beautiful. Your last oracle is gratitude. Gratitude makes sense of our past, brings peace for today, and creates a vision for tomorrow. So darling, once you make this choice, right now you are suffering. Look at you. You're so afraid, anxiety, overthinking, pessimism, negativity. But after you make that choice, there is nothing but positivity. You are going to be very grateful, right, that you stopped denying yourself this reward, this pleasure. So be brave. That is your advice from your higher self. Be brave. Right? Be very, very brave and just, you know, go out there and make this choice, right? Probably involving a Leo, a Capricorn, or a Cancer. And once you do, darling, you will have something to celebrate. Stability, wealth, right? Like the car that you picked is coming for you and eventually it's going to keep on growing. So stop worrying about the risks. Start looking at the brighter side of life, right? And you are going to be very grateful. Okay, the future is wonderful, but first, for today, you have to make that choice. I hope you enjoyed your reading. Thank you for joining me today, and I hope to see you again soon. Take care. If you chose protection, welcome to your reading. It's timeless. You are meant to see it right now. So, what advice does your higher self have for you? Let's start with tarot. The Five of Wands. The Hermit, the Eight of Wands, the Five of Pentacles, and the Two of Swords. Darling, this is quite serious. There is someone in your life who hurt you. The Five of Wands, this is the card of conflict, right? There is a relationship in your life that ended. It could be romantic or not. This could be a family member that we're talking about. This could be a friend, someone from your social circle, or it could be an ex-lover, right? But whatever it is, you felt hurt by this person. You know, towards the end of your relationship, it was like this person was very offensive. They were insulting you, you know, they didn't care about the things that you felt. They were invalidating your complaints, your feelings, your emotions, right? There was a lot of conflict, right? A lot of angry words exchanged between the two of you towards the end. And what you did is you made the right choice. You retreated from them, the hermit, right? This is the card of being alone. This is the card of staying away from this kind of energy, right? Enjoying serenity alone, right? Taking yourself out of this very negative situation. And that's amazing. It's great that you did that. Your higher self is proud of you for making that choice, right? For your peace of mind, right? Because of your self-worth, you decided to stay away from this person, and that is amazing. But now, here is the problem, darling. Communication, the Eight of Wands, right? This is incoming messages, outgoing as well. This is an exchange of words, of energy between two people. And right now, you're afraid of it. Look at you. Look at you. You are so anxious at the possibility, right? At the thought of communicating with this person, right? Every time the phone rings, you know, you're afraid that it's them. You just don't want to hear from them, and you as well. You know, it terrifies you thinking of texting them again or sending them a message. But, darling, that is actually far from the truth, okay? Maybe you're conscious. Maybe the surface of who you are is afraid of that. But look at your soul. This is your subconscious. This is who you are deep down. You are hungry for this Eight of Wands. You are thirsty for communication with this person, darling. You need closure from this person, okay? Or they need it from you, or both, right? This is your soul right now. You are actually yearning for this, longing for this, craving this closure. Closure is not the same as reconciliation, okay? It's not about forgiveness. It's just about understanding how you got there, right? From a loving, accepting relationship, how did you get to this very hurtful and harmful energy? This is about closing that part of your life, right? This is about closing that chapter, understanding why it happened, and then saying goodbye to it, right? And in the end, it's up to you. The choice is yours, the Two of Swords. This is the card of choices. The choice is yours and yours alone. If you want to reconcile with this person, if you want to forgive them, if you want to welcome them back in your life, right? Your higher self is not telling you to take that ex back. Your higher self is not telling you to make that girl your best friend again. Okay, your higher self is not telling you to go all sweet on your mom again, who was very hurtful to you when she found out your true path when it comes to your sexuality or spirituality or whatever else it is, right? No, your higher self is not dictating that you forgive and accept this person, but your higher self is telling you that right now you are starving. Your soul is thirsty and hungry for closure, for understanding, right? This chapter, it ended. What did I say? It ended very negatively, right? Lots of painful words exchanged, right? Maybe even physical attacks here and there for some of you. Very negative. And then you run away from it, which is great, right? Your higher self loves that you made this choice. But now, there is a need for the Eight of Wands. There is a need for an exchange of words, kind words, calm words this time, right? There is a need for closure. And on the surface, you know, your conscious mind is afraid of it, but really your soul, darling, deep down you are craving it. It's hard to heal, right? It's hard to close this wound when it hasn't been acknowledged, when it hasn't been recognized, darling. You need to exchange words and energy with this person, darling, right? You need to talk to them. You need to give each other closure, right? Forgiveness, reconciliation, that's up to you, but closure, understanding, closing this chapter, right? Acknowledging that you've been hurt. This is something that needs to happen. This is required, right? In your path, in your journey towards healing, this is something that you cannot keep being afraid of, darling. You have to welcome communication from them, or you have to initiate it yourself, darling. You need closure, okay? Right now, your soul is starving, right? But if this comes in, once this comes in, right? Once this conflict is addressed, once closure happens, then it's going to be fine, okay? It's up to you if you want to do anything beyond that, right? Forgiveness. If you want to forgive them, if you want to welcome them back in your life, that is up to you. Your higher self is not dictating what you must do when it comes to that. But you do need closure, darling, or you have a duty to give this to the other person. Either way, this is needed for your peace of mind, for you to have that serenity and tranquility again, okay? So when this comes in, or if it already has, then stop ignoring it, darling, right? Your higher self wants you to respond to it because it will give you the closure that your soul very much needs. That is your advice from your higher self. Let's see what your oracles have to add to this. We have thankfulness for understanding. What did I say? Understanding. Understand why this had to happen. Why it went from something so beautiful to something so ugly. Something so aggressive and hurtful. Right? This is all about closure. It says, before we can forgive one another, we have to understand one another. So, darling, I love this card. It's an echo of everything that your tarot cards just told you. It is up to you if you even want to forgive them, but you have to understand why this thing, this conflict, this rift happened between the two of you. And that can only happen with communication. So don't be afraid of it. Don't be afraid to reply to it or to initiate it, okay? Because your soul is in dire need of it. Your last oracle is prosperity and compassion. Prosperity is about growth. And growth cannot happen in your heart, in your mind, in your soul, if you are still stuck in this pain, in this failed relationship or connection, darling. And then compassion. This person probably needs compassion from you, or you need compassion from this person. Maybe both of you require it from each other at the moment, right? It says, prosperity depends more on wanting what you have than on having what you want. So it's not about wanting to have this person back in your life, right? That's something that I also said. That's something that Tarot also communicated to you. Rather, it's about being compassionate towards each other and trying to understand why you reached this situation, and it's about trying to give each other closure. So, darling, this advice is a revelation from your higher self. You're probably not aware of it because your conscious mind is here. This is where you are. You are swearing never to speak to this person again. You're so angry or you're so hurt. Either way, you just don't ever want to talk to them again. But your soul, your subconscious deep down needs it, darling. Okay, forgiveness, acceptance, welcoming back, that is up to you. Your higher self is not dictating that, but closure, understanding, compassion, these are things that you and this person, or, you know, this group of people need from each other right now. And once you have it, once you enjoy this Eight of Wands energy into your life, then everything is going to be fine. And the ball is going to be in your court, and it's you will have the power if you want to forgive and accept. But either way, right now you need closure, so don't be afraid to initiate or accept communication. I hope you enjoyed your reading. Thank you for joining me today, and I hope to see you again soon. Take care.